Hello and welcome to another episode of Pop Culture Reacts, and we are in the list of suggestions from you, the wonderful people out there, or should I say do, after our last video. And we are back.
Oh, fucking hell, that's going to be a running gag now, isn't it? I've just got to rely on our aged memories failing very quickly, so that gag disappears as quickly as it did, appear.
So we are back with some more half man half biscuit.
Oh, and by the way, I love the fact that we got a suggestion on this. When we got half man half biscuit on the channel, it was purely for my own amusements more than anything else, and I never thought that it would get more views other than me and you probably watching it back to make sure that it actually the video uploaded. But the fact that some people have not only listened, watched, subscribed off the back of it, and asked for more is heartwarming for me, because they are a band I love. But, as we said, I think on other videos, not one that I ever really expect is going to find that mass audience. You know, they're no Hasselhoff, are they?
They're no Hoff. But no. They are bringing us Asparagus next left.
From Acton Bono as well, which hotly debated, I guess, for all bands of what are their best album. But for me, at the very least, Acton Bono was the first full album of theirs I lived, and I think it has that kind of special place in your heart when it's the first one.
Yeah.
So there may be other albums that are as good, if not better. But yeah, this is the one that will always have that special place for me.
This is your baby of an album.
Yeah, and a quality name for an album as well, obviously.
Course. So shall we have some biscuits and some
Let's
men
do
cut
them in this. Half. We could do all of that, or we could just listen to the song, you murderous bastard. Right, let's do this.
We've just been performing a gorilla gig in the middle of another group's gorilla gig. Well, surely that's the ultimate gorilla gig, but still they cried like girls. Road signs on our country lanes may not be what they seem. Asparagus next left, who says I've been upstream? Going down there for plum tomatoes, that's not a good idea. When the club versus country dispute arose, small children were troubled in the exodus. We all knew someone at primary school who had a very powerful magnet. It's a way for new potatoes and arrow points in assembly. Track to a darker place, that's what it takes to be. Last chance for hanging baskets, they're even giving you clues. Fresh broad beans and aubergines, euphemisms are free euphemisms.
stopped it that time before going on to the next track. How about that for skills? What did you think of this Bicky song and its getting down to the real deepest core of emotion about Asparagus Next Left?
I can see the drive they're doing as they're writing this song.
Yeah.
Especially, like, you know, I'm in Norfolk, so you know, we have lots of those sort of farms or people that have got a vegetable patch out the back.
The horse manure 200 yards is a common sight for you.
You know, you drive any of the little roads, sort of, if you're going out to the coast or whatever, and yeah, you see these signs everywhere, you know, spuds here, green beans, asparagus, rhubarb, whatever. And you just sort of go, I've been on this journey, and they've literally gone, take that one, take that one, take that one, and just gone, let's make a fucking song out of it. And
And probably, like, as you say, the conversations they're having whilst on that drive, and they're integrating all that into the kind of the song, like the ridiculous conversations you're having. I mean, it's amazing that there, when the club versus country dispute arose, and you're kind of going, well, yes, at the time, like, everyone was always talking about that in football and things like that. Yeah. But that's probably what they're talking about as they're driving down the road. And, you know, like, any song that kind of, it, like, weaves in plum tomatoes, new potatoes, you know, it's... It's amazingly English in the way that they does it. And for lyrically, okay, you know, I think some of their songs, honestly, some of their songs do, I think, have some great social commentary in it mixed with the crazy humour that I think they do so well. And some of it doesn't. But even in that, it's just so, they're littered with smart one-liners throughout and just massively engaging one-liners.
Yes, I'm on the half man half biscuit train, definitely. It upsets me that I hadn't found these previously, because I didn't tell you, but when we did the first ones, I found out they played the Waterfront like 2 weeks beforehand, and I was like,
They play quite often, mate. There's one coming up in a couple of weeks, and I was too lazy to get tickets. I was too lazy to get them in time before they sold out. They are forever touring, and probably forever touring because they want to see road signs and things like that. And you know, they I guess testament or partially, some not testament, partially due to the size of them, but they do all manner of sizes of towns and villages that they'll play in. So I think. Until the sad day when they ever decide to call it quits, I think pretty much any point in the year, if you're willing to even just walk out your front door, you can probably find a live performance of them somewhere not too far away.
So yeah, it is one of those, if next time I see they're at the Waterfront or they're doing the Art Centre or something like that in Norwich, I'm going to go.
I'll come with you. How about that? I'll come out of retirement and come up and see the Bickies play. Yeah, I love it. It's a brilliant album for me. They've just got something very, very different about them. And, you know, I said it earlier, that very, very English element to it. And I could imagine for an international listener, a lot of this being even weirder. Well, don't get me wrong. Some of this is weird for an English, but at least there's like a connectivity to some of that oddity. Yeah. You know, like you've got a bloody verse about, whatever happened to the plumber's van, and it goes into transit vans, it goes into them, like the logistics behind them now, and you know, we grew up everything going on about van man, plumbers in white vans and things like that, and yeah, this is fantastic nostalgia mixed with humor, mixed with as I say, sometimes really smart and snappy lines. And you know, musically, I think the music always serves a really good purpose in it. You know, I think it fits the lyrics really well and fits the mood really well, and I don't want to do it down because I think it's really good, but you know, I'm kind of not going, oh, you know, this is the greatest thing since sliced bread. I just think everything comes together in such a nice humorous package that you know, everyone should listen to at least one half man half biscuit album in their life. Go for Acton Bono, because I think it is the most accessible of theirs as well.
Yes. Though, what did you guys out there think? Down there in the comments.
And after I waxed lyrical about how much of a joy it was to have Half Man Half Biscuit people talk to us in the comments, put some stuff in the comments, and if there's any other bands that float your boat for Half Man Half Bicky fans, drop them in as well, because I'm really intrigued to see, and I'm not, hopefully something relatively similar or something that may be in that wheelhouse. But yeah, as a fan who has quite eclectic tastes outside of this, you know, I'd equally listen to Public Enemy as I would this. Yeah. I'm always interested to know what Half Man Half Biscuit fans also listen to.
Yes, and as always, like, subscribe, ring the bell, and we'll be back very soon with more. Goodbye.